what I'm doing today, ladies and gentlemen, is opening with something that's normally relegated to the very end of the show. Right?
Well, that's very nice of you.
You take it. What am I saying? Let me ask Lauren Ellis, as in Ellis Island. What am I saying? What am I saying now? And this is unrehearsed, right?
Yes, totally unrehearsed. Totally unrehearsed.
What am I telling the audience? What am I doing now?
Well, he's introducing artists that are going to be really well-known in the future, and some very interesting ideas and perspectives of how we show our work and letting the public know that artists are human beings and we are normal and we can communicate.
But Mr. Corvino, what I'm saying, this is Paolo Corvino, another very gifted artist. What I'm saying is that art is generally low man on the totem pole. On a TV talk show, the art segment is usually Siberia at the very, very... You take it from there, Paul.
All depends what guests you have on.
Right. You being our deputy art critic of the moment, what do you think about Mr. Corvino's work?
I think that's a very nice idea, what they're doing, sponsoring for the AIDS organization, and it's the subject is very beautiful for that, very sensitive and very meaning and very strong.
And a noble gesture that makes that donation.
Very, very noble, yes.
Right?
It's very noble, yeah, and it's a good cause.
There are many, many talented artists out there, ladies and gentlemen, in the art world today. How would you describe your unique technique? I mean, in art.
Yes, in art. Well, that's good. Many techniques. Basically, what I do is a photo montage, and I create a fantasy portrait for people and corporations I've done. Commissions for Johnson & Johnson, Tampa Electric Company. I'm from Florida.
I'm gonna set up one of your videos right now.
Yes, that would be
let me ask my two artists together. How about any art predictions? Any art predictions for the next years or next decades? Not necessarily from you, but what's going to be in art?
You go first.
Okay, you go first.
I was going to say the Latin American art is coming out very strongly. Right. Latin American art, they're supporting it a lot. The show that they had at Queens Museum in New York and also in the Indianapolis Museum of the Latin American artists. I think that's really going to be happening. And Spanish and Latin.
Spanish and Latin.
Yeah.
A lady who experiments with many new ideas and getting tremendous press named Lauren Ellis, and many of our friends have said we've got to see one of her videos. We'll roll the video and you can talk as we play the pretty pictures on the screen. Our topic is the world of art, and Lauren Ellis, who is a princess in her field, will do the narration as we take a look at her works and lifestyle.
She has some great pieces there.
She's a very gifted young lady.
Thank you. This is a video presentation that I did as another form of showing your work. Most artists show their work by slides to galleries and things, but I wanted to do a video because it shows you more of the work, and when you talk on the video, it expresses the ideas, and this gets you to see the detail of the work. And basically, my background is Ukrainian descent, but even though I supported the Latin artists, and this is my Art Deco Miami Beach series here. Being from Florida, I did a commission for architects of Miami Beach, and so I superimpose images to create an emotional effect. It's a combination of images, and it's different fantasy-like things. When I do commissions for people, I like to create ideas of what means something to them. This is my flamingo series. Being from Florida, I have a lot of the beach in my work. This is a self-portrait I did. It was interesting. This is a portrait of my mother, and another technique I use. So I go and practice and play with different ideas in photography and painting. Actually, I call the work photographic painting. It's a combination of the painting and the photo. I wrote poetry to go with it, too, but it's a nice way to present the work in a short amount of time and make it more entertaining.
What an image for the Joe Franklin Show, right?
Thank you.
You sit here and meet some of my friends with me today, right? I'm chatting with Paul Corvino, with Lauren Ellis, whose many books include Photographs and Thoughts. You're going to photograph me today?
Oh, yes, definitely.
Like, I'm definitely going to.
Yes, yes. You already are.
Cary Grant look.
That Cary Grant look, right? Invitation time first from Lauren Ellis.
Yes. I'm going to have an exhibition at the Sands Hotel in the end of June, so in Atlantic City, so please look for that. And also, I'm represented by a couple of galleries in New York, if you're interested, at the Somerset Gallery in Melville and the Jeff Strickoff Gallery in Soho.
Are you always experimenting with new ideas?
Always experimenting with new ideas.
Never ending.
Technique is very experimental and always growing. And
we shall return following these words with more of what we call the big edition of the Joe Franklin Show. Don't ever leave me. Stay here.